Good day, good people. Bliss Waste Ice Beats here, and we got another one. This one's fun. We are applying a lobster claw to waste beads today. We don't see this one often, but we're doing it today. So let's get it going. Of course, you need your jump rings. We'll do two of those and your lobster claws. I use one jump ring on the claw. You see there? And then the second jump ring, I'll go ahead and use on the other end of the waist bead. So you'll get the tool, apply your jump ring onto your claw, and go ahead and get your bead spacer. You guys know I love the bead spacers because it just makes things a little neater. It covers up these extra knots that I like to instill in the waist beads. That gives it a bit more strength. But it's there, but it's, again, slightly covered up. So you want to toss that onto your waist bead. And here I'm using a big eye curve needle. And I'm going to then send the needle through the hole as I did. And then I'm going to tie a knot onto the jump ring. So that knot, and again, the angles here, my waist bead here slightly slipped off the table, but it doesn't matter on the first end because it really doesn't matter where you place your clasp. The second end makes the ultimate difference so that your beads are nice and tight. So you're gonna put a few knots there in the ring, and then we're going to send the S-Lon string through the bead spacer. And once you send it through the bead spacer, now it is your time to shine with as many knots as you like. You really don't want to overdo it, but make it nice and tight. You have nothing to lose. There's more than enough space in the bead spacers, so really twist it up and get it in there. Okay, so then we'll grab the other end and we'll get the shorter end and go ahead and let that go. Cut it with scissors, or you can use a singer here. Then we'll shove it into the bead spacer, and that's the knots. Now we're working on the other end. You want to pull your beads nice and tight, hold them in the air, make sure they're right next to each other, and then lie them down. Add the bead spacer right onto your S-Lon string, and here we're using the jump ring. So it's gonna be a little different here because we don't wanna show as many knots. Rather than put a knot around this jump ring, we'll send it right through the bead spacer. See that there? So no knot, send it right through the bead spacer. And now we're gonna use that as a little bit of leverage to get us as close as possible to the beads to make sure that the beads are nice and tight. And when it slips that way, it makes it a little bit more difficult. But again, it's the angles that I'm working with for you all. You want to pull it in the downward motion as we did in our last video working with nylon. Make sure it's nice and tight. And then lie it down and send a few knots right under the bead spacer. The knots have to go under the bead spacer because if they don't, you'll then snag an extra bead for absolutely no reason. It just doesn't look good, to be honest. So here we are again. It's time for us to make a few more knots in there right under the bead spacer. And this rarely happens, but in this particular video, I did have way more space than necessary right under my bead spacer. So I added a few more knots to make it a bit bulkier so that it goes right under and into the bead spacer. But normally, as long as you tug on the beads in the downward motion, it's nice and tight. So here we have our knot here, and we'll shove that into the bead spacer. And now you have one end, which is your loop, and then you have your claw. And now we're looking at a waist bead with a lobster claw on it, ready to go, removable. Subscribe, like, let me know what you think.